There's a big difference in an employee doing something because they're told to do it and doing something because they're inspired to do it. There's an old saying that a favorable performance recognized is most likely to be repeated. And let me tell you, that is a truism. It is absolutely irrefutable. So part of what your leaders must do is that you must look for ways to reward and recognize those members of your organization who do the most outstanding work as it relates to building your culture, representing your culture, sharing your culture, and living your culture. Because if it becomes known in an organization that you get rewarded, you get recognized by building this culture, by protecting this culture, by supporting this culture, by representing, presenting, and living to the culture of the organization, I promise you, people are all hungry for that recognition. We're all heat-seeking missiles for reward. And as leaders, sometimes we do get busy, and sometimes we fail to notice the little things people do every day to help our culture stay intact. I'll give you a quick example. Amanda Elmendorf, that works for me, got a phone call today from one of our new content providers, and he's so excited. He said, Amanda, I need 27 new demos set up for 27 potential clients. Do you think you could get that done for us in the next 7 to 10 days? You know what happened? She had those 27 new locations set up, personalized, branded, launched, and delivered in an hour. Because urgency to serve is a part of our culture. And I went up and thanked Amanda and said, I'm so proud of you. So you've got to always keep your eyes on your people and see the ones that are really making your culture a living, breathing thing. And take the time to reward them openly, publicly, and to give them the recognition they deserve for being that beacon, right? That bright light in your organization that makes your culture real.